Hey, good day there, guys. I got a couple radios here from some fellows down in Alabama. They sent two up at one time. Want me to go through basically the complaint from the phone conversation was they're underperforming. Not really doing what the expectations are, and apparently the fella that had previously worked on them, he's no longer around to take care of what issues they had. So they're up here now for me to go through and find out what's up. So let's get on with this, and I'll show you what we got. This is the first one. And, you know, I'm going to have both radios in one video. So, but almost a 2-watt dead key. About 5 bird. Almost 20 peak. And then look at the signal. Really, really nasty. So, I don't even know if I can straighten that up with the mic gain. Let's see if we can straighten that up. And that's about almost all the way off. And that still doesn't look good. So, almost all the way off. So, and then of course the watch just dropped. Just to clean it up. So, I'm pretty sure I've already got the screws out the case, got the lids. It doesn't look like anything real special. It looks like your normal Cobra 29 swing kit. You know, there's the resistor. Pop it open. You got your capacitor on the other side, little swing kit, and they've clipped the limiter, which is down there, so it's nothing extravagant. He does have an echo board in here, so I don't know why somebody couldn't have mounted it, but they taped it all up. That's the way it came to me. But normally if I do echoes, I try to mount them and don't do all that black tape crap. But we'll be back with an update, man. We're going to tune this rascal on up, man, and get her going for him. We'll be back. Guys, I sitting here getting ready to take the speaker off, and I got to looking. It's not even a stock final in here. It's 69, and it's doing 5 watts, so it's almost making me believe that that's one of those fake ones. One of those fake 69s, because this, I mean, this radio, just clipped and tuned, should be showing 7-8 RMS, so. And of course, the good old to remove the tuning slug. I love these guys that do that. Just a little quick update, that's all. We'll be back. Alright guys, we're back on Richard's radio here, man, and well, Mr. I guess his handle's Superfly, and this is what we got. Now your variable power now is in the RF gain. Alright, so let's get on with the show. There's your reference on the scope. 1K tone going through there. Look at that. Right there, 200% modulation. I think it's beautiful, man. Worked out great. It's really a hair over 200, but it's right there at the 2. And then 50-watt slug. We're a little over 3-watt dead key. Oh, yeah. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It's about 13 RMS. Oh, yeah. And there it is in the corner. So we'll switch this out. We're going to put the 100 in there. 100-watt slug. Peak side. Oh, yeah. A little over 70. And there you go. And just to my RMS peak meter over here. Oh, yeah. Hello, 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 hello. On, 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 on. So, I've got a little warm now. I was hitting actually about 55 on the RMS, which is really good for this radio. So, but there you go. We will be back with the next unit. All right, guys. We're back on the second 29. And this one apparently must be Dirty Dogs. And we're going to give this thing a good look through. Frequency's a little off. Not bad, though. Almost 2-watt dead key. We're back on the 50-watt slug. Clear up. There we go. Four and a half. Not even nailing 20. And let's go on with this with the whoops, too loud. Yeah. Just yeah, the reference ain't there, but look at the square tops. I don't know if y'all can really make that out, but it's squaring off. And I didn't touch the mic gain. I left it where he had it at, so which is 9 o'clock. That's pretty bad. Yeah, still squaring. Turn almost all the way off. Hold on. There we go. Now, see that? Looks good there by adjusting the mic gain, which is fine. I have no problem with that. But the negatives, look at the negatives. They're all flat across, so that's not good. No curvature there. And it's 50% modulation. So not good at all. These radios probably really didn't sound good. Let me see if I can get it up to 100. See, once I start getting anything over about 80%, 80% right there, the negatives still look like crap, flattened across, but at least he's round positives. That's real close to his 9 o'clock he had, but it's only 80% modulation. So, not good. Not good at all. We will be back with an update on this one once we get it, get into it and find out what we got going on. They were 1969s, and I'm going to test them against a known good one. I got a funny feeling because the watts these things are making. Let me see if I can get a good picture of it. I got a funny feeling they're fakes, they're knockoffs, and I haven't tested it yet. So we're going to give them a good test and see what we come up with. We'll be back with an update. All right, hello guys. Back on Dirty Dogs Radio, and the same as his buddies. Variable power is right here on the RF gain. That's where we have it at. So let's get on with this. And I'm going to show y'all something here at the end of this video. Got the scope hooked up. Let's check the reference. Our reference is relatively close. And look at that. A lot better. See that center where them negatives are round instead of going flat across? It's about 225% modulation. It's probably a little more since I didn't calibrate the scope. Just a quick check. Perfect. Looks beautiful. Over here, we're going to be working the 50-watt slug. Let's clear up a little bit. 50-watt slug. We're reading the middle scale. So, of course, the 10 is the 10 watts. Yeah. On. It's right there at about the 14. Right there about the 14. We'll hit peak real fast. Of course, 50-watt slug. Yeah. And in the corner. So we'll flip this one out. I'm going to put the 100 in there. So now we're going to be reading the bottom scale. So that 20 would be 20 watts, 40, 40, 60, 60, 80, 80, 100, so forth. Yeah, hello, 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 hello. Look at that 90. And the RMS peak meter. Yeah, hello, hello, hello. So not bad at all, man. I mean, not bad at all. This is one of the ones with the YO chip in it, which I've always said, you know, they do a hellacious amount of peak. But at the end of this video, what I wanted to show you is they had fake 1969s in here. I checked them on my transistor checker for one. They really read off. But this one right here, that's a fake. And that one right there is a real one. Okay, and if you look at the printing on them, man, the printing really looks good. But look at how it's set on the transistor. It's offset. It's a little too low on the transistor, and it's off to the right-hand side. Dead giveaway. The Chinese try, but they don't duplicate it exactly correct. So I figured I'd include this in the video, you know, the fake 1969. I know there's other videos online about them, and that's pretty much why these radios just weren't doing the watts, for one. Two, I'm not really even sure what the audio sounded like over the air, because I really have never dealt with the fakes before. But these were fake 1969s, and this is a real one. This one right here is real. That's the fake. So there you go, fellas. We got you all done up. I'm gonna be posting this video here shortly. Your two radios will be coming back to Alabama, and y'all will be talking, no doubt about it. Old Stickman at the No Name Amp CB shop. If this is something that you have that you need to have done, give me a shout. I will help you out. We'll see you guys. Bye bye bye.